Hello guys, and welcome to a new series called FIFA 19, Arsenal Career Mode. And as you guys see, right now I'm going for the options, changing my name, and choosing my country. As you guys see, I choose Wales. But I hope you guys do enjoy the series. If you guys can get involved if you want, you can comment, do what you want, you know, put who you want me to buy, who you want me to sell. And I know a lot of the transfers that, or transfer listed players I put up there are going to make some people mad. But you got to think about it. That's only if it's an outrageous amount, and those players are either 2 year old or they're so young that their potential is already ruined at the beginning. And as you know, I'm looking at the Europa League. Looks like I'm going to be a good contender to make it to the semifinals, because only team I see in there that could be a problem was in group like D. And as you can see, I'm just looking through this. The Champions League in the season is going to look pretty amazing. I'm on professional difficulty. Currency I use is dollars because I'm an American. And I'm not the best, so I do use professional. Yeah, shut up, Jared. But you guys are going to hear a chant that I found on YouTube, which I find pretty cool. If you copyright the video, that doesn't matter. You're not going to get any ad revenue. But hope you guys do enjoy the series, and leave a like, subscribe, and I'll see you guys later. You get to hear my voice twice already in about like 2 minutes in the video, but as you see, I'm putting up basically anybody above the age of 29. And some of the 29-year-olds, yes, I know I'm going to keep, like Ozil, I plan on keeping for a season, same with Aubameyang. But Mkhitaryan is just kind of like a player that's like I want in my squad, and you'll see I experiment with him both games that I play. But I just don't see why I would keep him. He's 29, which means next year he's going to be getting pretty old. While this season, if I sell him, I can get a good price and buy somebody younger, like a 21 or 22 year old that I can work with, kind of like James Ward-Prowse. I think he's 23 this year though. But other suggestions for midfield, I'm willing to hear them. And then I kind of just go down here and I'm like, yeah, some of these players I don't want, because I do have a youth scout that I put out later on in the video. I don't show you guys it, but yes, I do. And there are some players on here that I don't plan on getting rid of, but I put up there just in case there's a good price tag for them. Like Zlatan, he's probably going to stay for a season or two just so I can get like my team set up to the point that I'm good. But, yeah. This is my first, This is my first competitive game, actually preseason game, but as you can see, I put Aubameyang in, even though I was talking about how older players are not going to play as often. And the Arsenal anthem that I just played for you there, that wasn't the full song, but you will hear it over time in the episodes. I'm just giving you a little taste, and if you're watching past that point, then you're lucky, because that was a weird YouTube video I found. But other than that, I'm just gonna, you're gonna hear my voice over some music, but the music's gonna be a lot quieter so you can hear me and talk while I talk about the game. So basically, the starting lineup for Real Betis kind of seems like they're using most of their like bench players, and they have Honda, I don't know how to say, the middle defender. Their team is based around that guy, as I assumed by the formation. And Barfa there is just like a center back that I see is probably going to play stopper most of the game. And I take advantage of that. And let's kick off. As you can see, Glaskin, I'm going to butcher names, okay? This is Arsenal. Nobody likes half of their names. But Urso gets a good pass to Xhaka, who sends it out to Mkhitaryan, as I said, was going to experiment. And he just doesn't have the pace that I want for a winger. And as you guys see, I use Hector Bellerin for like a majority of the winger. I don't show most of his clips because he does lose the ball. But he's got some good foot skills, no joke. If I had him on my real life soccer team, he'd definitely be winger, not a center, not a right back. But William over here has a chance. He passes it to Junior, who is their left back at the time. Or left wing back because of the defense setup they have. This is just brilliant. I'm already bored, already talking. But Inuna sends in a cross that Holding does stop right for Mustafa to clear right to Aubameyang. Aubameyang just kind of messes with the defense. Waiting for a pass, he gets it to Ozil. Ozil lobs it over to Mkhitaryan. He gets a good touch, but it just wasn't to the direction and takes a shot. That was a misclick of a button. And as you can see, this Union guy is going to be in most of the defensive clips because he did absolutely amazing. I even looked into his stats and I was tempted to get him. Oh, Wabia. Yeah, I'm not going to butcher that name. But he keeps it in with a very nice finesse touch. And Xhaka loses the possession. As you can see, we just cleared it. Aaron Ramsey gets the ball. Does a through pass, I guess, to Iwobi. Waits for an opening. Passes it right to Kolasinac. And Kolasinac runs it. Takes a stop right there. Crosses to Aubameyang. And probably the best shot of the game. We do get more shots, and there are more scoring opportunities with Aubameyang. But that was just such a great chance that I was kind of surprised I didn't score that. Same with Aubameyang. As you guys see, Junior passes to Aubameyang as soon as, this is right after this clip. And gets slide tackled brilliantly for Mkhitaryan to get the ball. And send a nice through ball to Aubameyang, which he finesses the defender in the box. Takes a shot, gets deflected off a defender. Another chance wasted by Aubameyang. As you guys see, I'm just fiddling with who I can get the ball to. Ozil becomes the target, goes right to Aubameyang. Aubameyang shoots it, and it's deflected by the goalkeeper. At this point, I just thought, it's game over. There's no way I'm getting one past this goalie. So I send a through ball right to Iwobi, and he can't get the ball either. That Sid guy is just sitting back there waiting for it. That's what I hate about five defense formations. You got those two fullbacks, or wingerbacks, either too far up or too far back. That leads to me doing some swapping with my team. And as you can see, I literally swap about everybody through the period. And you'll see that because I got really kind of crazy and I got mad. And as you can see, Milan Niles is just running around. Like, I just put him in. I'm using his stamina. I know he doesn't have much of it, but he's got good agility. And that's all I wanted from him. And they get an absolute stunner of an opportunity. But Leon Lino is just right there to stop it. Always follow Manuel Neuer's footsteps. And yes, guys, I will stutter for all this series. As you can see, Kolasinac does a stunner back heel. Like, I'm sorry, guys. I'm falling behind on this commentary just because I'm getting... Toria gets a good flick with a back heel to stop it from progressing. But Bellerin's the one who puts an end to the attack. Kolasinac just tries to look for a pass. Gets it to Iwobi. Wabi doesn't do so well with the chest trap, passes it back to him. He sends it to Tora. Tora sends it right back to him, and this is the best chance of the game. Aubameyang gets in there, gets around a defender, takes a shot, and scores, putting Arsenal 1-0 up at the 58th minute. And 30? Actually, why would I even do the second? That's a loser. Aubameyang celebrates with his teammates from last year, knowing that this is going to be their season because of the new manager. As you guys see, I am sending in multiple subs, but oh no, I was wrong. Only one sub went in through that goal. Aaron Ramsey. Torreira Kolaskin sends it to Iwobi out wide. But Iwobi's about to do a 1-2. Oh, he thought. Out jukes a defender. Ramsey gets in. Tries to replicate what Aubameyang did, but it took a deflection and Aubameyang shot from being offside. Iwobi gets fouled right here for trying to pass the ball. It just does not look good for Real Betis at this point in time. Niles, it does a great, I don't know what that was, but that was a great skill move that got past the defender. But as you guys see, you can tell that Real Betis and the Clips start getting really aggressive with this side of their wings, because the other side I just think is too weak for the team. And here comes my three subs that I was talking about earlier. Lacazette comes in for Aubameyang because I wanted Aubameyang for the next game against Milan, and you guys will see why. Remember, this is stage 3 of group stages, which is the third match that I kind of, we were already guaranteed to go through, and I was like, you know, I'm going to play the game. I'm not going to pronounce the name. And as you can see, another reason Lacazette was put in is I saw his phenomenal play back when he used to play in the French League. You know, I really wanted to see if I could make that happen at Arsenal. But as you can see, they are getting so aggressive from that side that it's gotten to the point I know what side they're going to press, and I've been moving my left back more to the center so one of my center backs can help, because I play a 4-4-1-1, I think, yeah. And as you can see, what a beautiful through ball that could have been a shot if it had more power to it. It's immediately cleared. Francis becomes the new threat when they focus on this side, and they actually could have had a shot that would have did it 1-1. And I'm just at this point just trying to get minutes into the video, because that's why I'm showing you this. But they kind of just passed around, almost had a chance, but it ended, you know. Games like, nah, we ain't dealing with this. We go straight into the next game, which is unedited, so you're going to hear my voice stop every once in a while, because, you know, I'm tired and I don't want to do this, because it's like, yeah, it's like 11 a.m. where I am. Not 11 a.m., 11 p.m. And as you guys see, I'm using Hector Bellerin way too much this game already, and Rodrigo, who is their left back, I've been looking at him in my transfer hub, because I think he could be a starter. And somehow this is a foul on Bellerin. I did slide tackle, but I tried, but he got clacked right before I did, and he immediately gets a yellow in the 4th minute, which makes me more worried to use him up top, because I think he's an aggressive player like that. But yeah, you'll see why I didn't cut this as much. Because honestly, it's just attack versus attack. Defense has no way of stopping this. And as you see, it got to the point where I just cleared it. You know, the 6th minute, so. But you'll see, I start clearing it immediately as soon as it gets in the box. I did do that last game, but I would always try to take my chances. That's one of the reasons why that Conte striker or whatever always slides tackles. Because each AI, I feel, has its own playing style. And I try to maneuver around that. Failed attempt by Mkhitaryan to finesse a midfielder leads to a chance that could have greatly helped Milan out. Luckily, we had Milan in goal. Ramsey gets aggressive defense, and actually, it was offsides, I think. No, it was a foul. Sorry, guys. Leon has proven that he's probably going to be my starting goalie over Pedicek, who I'm also trying to get rid of from age. And he's getting to the point in his career where he should be playing in League 2 at least. Maybe even, if he's lucky, a Champions. Not Champions. The Barclays Champions or whatever. He was a great goalie, but his time's over. As you see, my defense passes it around, sends it back to the goalie, and does a really cool trick that I thought was pretty cool, because I didn't mean to. I was trying to get my pass, like, correct in this direction. Aubameyang gets through the defense and just claps it right into the back of the net. I'm not super hyper about this goal, because It's Aubameyang. He's known for scoring these baddies, getting past the defense, and then just absolutely scoring that. The crowd's going wild, and I mean wild. Everybody's screaming, you know, the usual. And guys, while we're sitting here in the boring little part for a little bit, do you guys like the music? If you want, make a suggestion. Make sure your music isn't too racist. I'll play music if it's like Rucka Rucka Ollie kind of meme music. But if it's like just pure racism, don't talk to me about it. You know, that's bad. Hector Bellerin at the wrong time tried to juke a striker out. I think he's actually a winger, but pass goes right to our center back, who gets it right to Iwobi. Rizal gets it, tries to send it to Aubameyang, but it's offside. I saw that Aubameyang was offside, but I wanted that goal. Really bad. Really wanted that goal. It looks like I could have got Aubameyang a hat trick at the moment. That's all I was thinking about was, if I score a hat trick with Aubameyang, I'm going to drink me a nice salt. Aubameyang gets another terrible touch, but tries to recover it from after losing it to the left back, Rodriguez. But Rodriguez, it went out of bounds from so much power. Xavier and the Bigla guy, Bigla, kind of got into like a little bit of a shoving game right there. Xhaka sends it all the way over to Iwobi, which could have been a good chance because Iwobi does get that. Goes right to Mkhitaryan, and this is where I think I decided I want Mkhitaryan in the team. Even though I misclicked the finesse shot or whatever that new thing they added in FIFA 19 is, we still scored with Mesut Ozil. It was a great header, even though the goalkeeper should have got to it. Wasn't enough power. Wrong time. Three goals for Mesut Ozil in this like trophy, international cup, I should say, European. Now they're mid. I think this is the point where Milan's like, yeah, we need to step up our pressure. We need to be more aggressive. But just in the nick of time, Aubameyang almost got another goal. But Dom, who is actually a phenomenal goalie. Yeah, I'm stuttering again already. Phenomenal goal. Done. As you guys see, our defense just felt like heading the ball no matter what. Higuain, the pizza man, gets a good play for his team, but just nobody else could get it. And I don't know what Iwobi tried to do right there, but it could have been a good play, but it just didn't work out. And a nice clear by Hector Bellerin, which makes him want me to put him up for corners, because if he can head like that in an actual like Premier League game, he could be a dominant force in there. Milan gets a counterattack that could be deadly. Gets a nice shot in, but Leon, no problem saving that. Just saying, We Are Arsenal is going to get really repetitive. As Iwobi dribbles past a defender, trying to get Aubameyang a good run in, finally sees it. And Aubameyang just drills it right into the back of the net right before first half ends, giving him two goals to his name. And the hat trick, he can sense it on the tip of his lips. He wants that hat trick, and he's going to get it. A nice cross by, I think it was a defender that made that cross, or a midfielder. I couldn't really tell, but honestly, a nice header, because none of my men were guarding him. I don't get that, because should have been Hector Bellerino's man. But, you know, it's one goal. We can keep the lead, right? As you see, now that they know they can score and make a comeback, they are just absolutely attacking. I have had no chance to even get my offense ready. So I just start messing around with Urso, which is exactly what happened. What a nice pass by Iwobi. It's a 1-2. Can the cross connect? And it does not. As you can see, I get a little bit tripsy with my shots, and it goes right over the net. That was no mess up right there. See, his stats even proved that he should probably get a hat trick. Both shots were on target, both shots were goals. And I put Matt Lyon and Niles for Ixhaka, because I don't want Ixhaka to be tired just in case I do make it to the finals, which looks like I will. Kloskin kind of messes up with his run, and I'll take fault for that. I feel like if it wasn't the AI, he could have recovered faster. But it's a great pass to Iwobi. Ooh, what a nice dribble by them. Can Milan make another goal in the amount of time? Looks like they're getting there. And it could have been a good chance, but Bellerin fouls, which means they are getting a free kick, which is something I did not want to risk. So I put in Torre for Ramsey just to help out with our midfield just a little bit. And knowing how good Milan's been making their team with free kicks and defense, I put a guy back there just in case. And it hit crossbar. If that was just a little bit lower, it would have been guaranteed goal, no matter what. Leon or Linon would have never got there. And Iwobi tried to do something a little bit fishy, but it did not work out. Ursal is just getting physically abused right there until Kloskin shows up. Can he get his second assist of the game? And it looks like Aubameyang is there, but Iwobi is selfish and tries to take the shot. I did want to get him a goal. He's a youngster that I want on the team in the future. Cassie is honestly a good player and could become a future candidate for a midfielder that I want on the team. Because honestly, most of these early games are just me looking for players. I don't plan on winning this, but if I do, I guess that's a plus side. Because as you see, Mkhitaryan gets a great opportunity to get across him, but just could not win the header. Mustafa sends it right to Kloskin. He's seen one of these maneuvers before. And it looks like he's going to play to Iwobi, and it looks like it's going to be a good cross, but he is getting swarmed by three players. And it is to give Aubameyang the hat trick. Honestly, that wasn't Iwobi. That was a good shot, Iwobi. That was him. Okay, I'm starting to stutter and mess up my words again. But Aubameyang puts it in for the hat trick. This deserves him a starting spot against Man City for our first Premier League game. Lacazette I do put in here after this just to get him some playing time and even see if I can score with him. Because I want every player on this chance to have a goal opportunity. Milan looks like they're still weak like they always were. And at this moment I decide Danny Welbeck, he's not in form because of the simulated games and some other undisclosed issue from last game somehow, that I've just decided, you know, I'm going to put everybody in, give them as much playing time as I can, and I think Elneny goes in later because I want Mkhitaryan. Actually, I think, it's this one that I do that. I put mid lane out wide again because he seems to be a very dangerous crosser if you give him the opportunity. That's exactly what I want for the team, a crosser that can dribble and is a youth player that I can work a team around. But at this point, I have three to four candidates that I want to try this out with. James Ward-Prowse, he could be a nice candidate. He's a right mid, could be center mid if you really need it. And they get a chance to score, but Linon stops that. Back onto that topic, Hector Bellerin. He's also another candidate that I've been thinking about, even though I shouldn't really try to base the team around him. And then Leno, which of course would be a nice candidate because he is a young goalie. And we immediately struggled, but luckily it was an offside shot. Other than that, I think Iwobi maybe. He doesn't look like a leader though. He looks like he needs somebody to help him when he needs it. Matt Linaus though, I don't know, but he's just got that candidacy in my head. Like, yeah, I'm gonna definitely need him. You guys know I don't own James Ward-Prowse, but he is a transfer target I was thinking for. Same thing with, I can't remember his name, Man United player, Anthony Martial. Yeah. He's also another youthster that is a winger that we could base a team around. Get a few good head like strikers with a head like Harry Kane, and we've got a team set up. So Chris kind of makes a weird maneuver right there, and it does not work out for him. Conte gets the thing in, and it's a rebound goal to make it 4-2 in the 81st minute. Milan at this point in time are just like, yep, we're ready. Hope you like those scalps. Elneny is becoming a center defensive mid that honestly I feel like could be a future center back if I really needed, because I am trying to get rid of, I think, three out of the four defenders that play center back on this team. And if I can't find a replacement in time, he probably would become a starting center back, honestly. Elneny doesn't have too much defensive skill in my knowledge. I'm going to check after this. I'm going to look at most of their stats. But other than that, I feel like, yeah, he could be a good center back to help Mustafa out there. Hector Bellerano could probably even get him a haircut. Yeah, only true Arsenal fans understand that joke, and I'm not a true Arsenal fan. I'm trying to get Zlatan a goal, but, you know, it doesn't work. And this is pretty much the last chance we get in the game. And, yeah, after that, I kind of just mess around. But if you guys want to see more games like this, unedited, me and music, you know, we could have a nice casual conversation. And Matt Lane, in the 92nd minute, shoots a shot like that. I even went into replay mode because of how glorious this was. So as you see, you have Mustafa over here, ready to like, do some cool stuff. Sends it like that. Goes right through the butt cheek and out that penis. Yeah, I had to replay that just to make sure. Guy sends it. Like, that was the best goal. If that went in, I was gonna cry. Other than that, the game ended, and, you know, we plotted the refs being like, yo, thanks, man, for giving him a yellow in the 4th minute. And I hope you guys enjoy this. If you want more like this and more gameplay of this, leave a like, subscribe, show me you want more, comment down below who I should get or buy. And if you lasted 27 minutes, give your nipples a little touch, because this is where I try to buy Anthony Martial. Just give me some space. Why you all up in my face like you need a taste? Good designer on my way. Shooters keep the K. I tell them boys to play it safe. Don't lay in your grave. I ain't never taking time off. I'm steady grinding. I'm never lying. Was never crying. Take flights, I'm flying. No, you can't see me. Say you need me, but you deceive me. And I got all the